The flame that burned and wax that melted. A short story. She entered the classroom with a tender smile on her lips. It was a space for her to forget the hardships she held in her heart deep within. Laurel was on her first day at first grade. Her charming voice, short hair tied up to a ponytail with a red ribbon, and the plain blue frill frock she wore didn't allow her sorrows to come up to her face. At least, she looked blissful outside. Every little kid looked radiant and sunny. There were eagerness filled in their tiny faces. Laurel sat on the second row. She was coming from a small family and she was the only child. She never had her childhood days wrapped in parents' love or laughter. Her father was a drunkard and her mother suffered the worst. There were nights Laurel pressed herself against the pillows and fought back her tears while her parents fought. On the days of arguments and yelling, they hardly cared about their little daughter's soul. School and friends were her only relief. One fine morning, the teacher tapped the desk for a break from those chirpy voices of the kids. "Lower your voice. Now it's your teacher's turn to talk," the teacher said loudly. The noise came to a pause. The teacher said, "You always pray to our mother, Marian Theresia, right? But does anyone know the glory her soul holds?" "No, teacher," the kids said in their usual rhyme. "Yes, so I'm going to distribute you all a cartoon book. It's for the children of your age to know who she really was. Won't you all read?" the teacher asked by giving the books. The little minds became curious as they received the books. That night, Laurel opened the book the teacher gave. Her father has not yet reached home and her mother was cooking. She turned the pages. The pictures seemed quite attractive. She explored more and more about the hardships Marian Theresia went through. She was very keen to read the whole book by night. The devotion that Marian Theresia as a child showed to Jesus was quite amazing to her. She realized how longing her soul was to dissolve herself for the needy and helping families. With a few pages left, Laurel's eyes grew tired and she slept with her hands still on the pages. From that day, the hope in the little girl arose. She hailed Marian Theresia as a savior. She kneeled down in front of her idol and prayed for her family. The little girl never yearned for her own happy days, but for a family which was side by side, sharing togetherness. Laurel became a constant listener of the miracles unwinded from the hands of the mother. She knew more about how mother sprinkled sparkles over every needy. Gradually, some changes took shape in her life too. Her father was taking transformation, and Laurel, along with her mother, was amazed at it. Those blissful days were back again. One day, while Laurel lighted a candle in front of Marian Theresia and closed her eye, she felt a gentle touch, light as a feather, on her cheeks. Might be an imagination of her little mind, but when she opened her eyelids, she felt Marian Theresia's idol smile at her. The lighted candle glowed her face. The flame that burned was her commitment, and the wax that melted was her devotion. Genia M. 11B.